Let's listen to Johnny Cash. He's humming right now. He's thinking, then he's gonna tell you.
I keep a close watch on this heart of mine. I keep my eyes wide open all the time.
Johnny Cash keeps his eyes wide open all the time, and I'm going to suggest an additional line to that. I keep my nose smelling all the time. Today's topic, yeast, molds, fungi in food. Here's my first warning, and I'll close with it. Don't eat contaminated food. If you see yeast, you see molds, you see fungus, don't eat it. Some molds cause allergic reactions and respiratory problems. Why? Because they're growing in your lungs. You aspirate them, you breathe them in, or you're living in that environment. These few molds can contain mycotoxins. We're going to talk about what that is. It's a plant that generates certain types of response chemicals. So they're poisonous. They either make you sick or kill you. What we're talking about is people that eat in food. I'm going to ask you a general question. Look at those three products. Would you buy them, A? Would you eat them, C? Or would you throw them away? A, B, C. Eat, buy, throw away. Hopefully, you wouldn't eat it. Two, you wouldn't buy it. And three, you would throw it away as fast as you got it in a contained area. Why? Because those organisms, those plants, are spreading around all around you. Next slide. All right, where do they live? A lot of them live in the outdoor environment. They were here before humans got here. They're going to live after we're gone. They live out there, and then they travel in what are known as spores. If you have an allergic reaction to any kind of the spores, and a certain time of year, you get your eyes all watery, you're sneezing all the time, your throat is full of phlegm, you can look for those little guys. There are a lot of reasons why. But look what they do to that piece of fruit on the top right-hand side. In the Central Valley of California, we grow a lot of fruit. One of our biggest enemies are those little bugs. Every environment, both indoors and outdoors and year-round, people say, oh, in the snow we don't have them, Andy. Yes, you do. Growth of those organisms is helped by a warm and humid condition. Well, Andy, it's snowy in Minnesota. That's great. Let's go inside your house where it's all toasty and warm, and it has a lot of humidity. We can go to outdoors areas, which would be the shady, damp areas, places where leaves or other vegetation are decomposing. So if you do a lot of hiking, make sure you clean off very carefully your boots before you go back in, and you take off those clothes because you're just embedding them in those organisms. Indoors, we talked about a high humidity level. Let's talk about how those organisms grow inside a house a little later. So molds, they form spores. Then they dry, then they float through the air, and they can come all the way from China. I'll talk about that in another episode, a session of this program, but spores can fly through the air, and there's what's called the jet stream. They can fly for thousands of miles, and they'll start their growth cycle again. That's the nature of all living things. Next slide. All right. Mold inside of food. Believe it or not, your refrigerator stops doing its real job after 4 days of a product being in there. If I see a refrigerator like that, particularly when I do restaurant or food safety inspections, that's no longer a food storage facility. You know what that is? That's what they call a biology experiment. You're seeing how sick that food could get before you could serve it to somebody. Look at that gross piece of cheese in that craft product. Somebody kept it too long. Number one, it comes with a barrier. That was taken off. You can see the residue of it. And then it has the top lid taken off, and it was allowed to grow from whatever was inside that refrigerator, inside that product. Would you eat it? Hopefully no. Isn't anybody in my listenership that would open that open and take a bite? What you see is the same thing, cross-contaminating a piece of bread that was in that same refrigerator. So open your eyes, keep a close watch on this heart and this body of yours. The surface of food, if it has any kind of grayness or darkness or fuzzy green dots or anything, even white dust, coin-sized velvety circles on fruit or jellies, don't eat it. It's simple. You know that. I don't think there's a human out there that would take a bite of that. Heavy mold growth can actually come from the inside of a penetrated piece of food. So they have root threads. They actually, like a plant, will go deep down into the food. So if you just cut around it and eat it, you're still at risk. toxins spread throughout the food. That's what we're talking about. These plants poop and they pee. How's that? Does that make sense? Does that bring it down for most people to listen to? It's all the way down. If you cut off just the bad part of an apple, like my grandma used to do, I'd get sick a couple hours later. Next slide. Here's a particularly deadly form of these types of pathogens. They're called aflatoxin. One of my clients does birdseed, and they're very worried about that. Why? Because it's not fit for human consumption, but they know that humans will eat it. Well, let's look on the top left. You'll see a scanning pictograph of an aflatoxin. Again, these plants, we can see them on the top right-hand side of that corn. That's what they look like. The birdseed has corn. The clients say, hey, Andy, what if some human eats it? I said, it's very unlikely, but we better still check for it. And that there are none of their buyers will buy their product if it's tested positive for aflatoxin. That's one of the links to carcinogenic situations or in patients or sicknesses. It also causes the following litany of items on the far right-hand side: mental impairment, abdominal pain, vomiting, convulsions, edema. That's where your skin gets big. Hemorrhaging. That's why when a patient comes in a hospital, who's ever doing their preliminary diagnosis should ask, what kind of environment do you have? So it's cancer-causing, it's a poison, it's a fungus or a plant-type deal, and it feeds on corn and peanuts. So that's why those companies should not ship if they have aflatoxin. It's also a form of mycotoxin. It's all over around us. If you have animals, any kind of livestock, it usually means cows, burros, horses, domestic animals like dogs and cats, and other humans that have it, they could transmit it to you. So many countries limit the exposure to these types of aflatoxins, and they test, and they don't feed it to the public if that's in it. Next slide. All right, here's a particular type, a very large fungus. And you should exercise extreme caution with fungus, especially mushrooms. Some people might say, Andy, we've been eating mushrooms in France for a million years. Fine. If you just go out into the woods and say, this looks just like an edible mushroom that I saw on the Discovery Channel, that's not a good move. All of these mushrooms that you see these pictographs of are actually poisonous to the human system. They produce toxins. If you eat them raw, or even if you cook them, Andy, I boil them in a soup and I've never had a problem. They are higher species of fungi. You see people in movies eating them, they just boil it. That's a movie. So what I'm saying to you, most mushrooms have human poisoning values. They're not made safe by cooking, canning, freezing, or any other kind of processing. But before you eat a mushroom, you need to be very careful. I know there are some mushrooms that produce a psychological alteration. You should be very cautious about that. And don't eat poisonous mushrooms. That's a close of that section. Next slide. Okay, here's what I'm trying to say about molds. Again, all of these are different. You eat a strawberry like that, you're in trouble. You eat bread like that, you're in trouble. Eat an orange like that. You eat a piece of bread like that. Or if you see any kind of blotches in the basement of somebody's house or building, you might get an apartment very cheaply in the basement of a building and you see that, don't go. So don't buy moldy food. Examine it. That means smell it, look at it. Check the food in a glass jar. If you see that lid is popped, don't buy it. Check your refrigerator. Clean it. Here's a little formula. It's very easy. Just put some baking soda and some water and clean it. Scrub the visible mold and clean everything with some bleach after that. You keep your dish towels, your sponges, your mops clean and fresh. I've talked about this in a different segment. That's where the mold can grow. Smell it if it's musty. Don't ever take a towel from somebody's house that hasn't been freshly cleaned. That's a good way to get as sick as they are. Keep the humidity level wherever you live less than 40%. Why? Oh, and Andy, I like it when it's cold outside. I come in here, it's really nice and warm and toasty. You're going to have challenges with mold. Next slide. Here are mold examples in living spaces. If you ever see that, you need to get out of that house. Even the workers that come in and clean that out, it's very expensive. Insurance companies do have coverage. They have masks. They have suits. They don't want to take that stuff home to their families. So remove the high humidity. You want to have lower humidity. That's 60 to 75 is better than 80 to 100. I like it around 40. Empty the collected water that condensates outside because it's in there. The little spores are in there. They haven't had time to grow yet. You control the growth on your clothing, your shoes, and a lot of times you see these little bags that come from electronics, from China or Japan or Taiwan. That's called a desiccant, and it removes or collects the moisture inside that bag with a chemical reaction. That's it. Can also find it in shoes and clothes. That's the reason. Next slide. Here are my suggestions, people. If you're listening, look at that hot dog up there. How many people would like to eat that? A, it's been out too long. Don't eat it. That sandwich is horrid. And don't live in an area where you can actually see that mold growth in a corner where it's wet. That whole building needs to be sanitized and probably rebuilt in that area. Look, smell, accept or reject. Everybody does it, even a dog. If you try to give a dog that hot dog, they wouldn't eat it. They'd smell it and walk away from it. They know it's bad for them. Search for mold wherever you live. You're usually going to find it under a sink. You're going to find it under a corner where some interior piping is leaking. Dry living space is always better. I'm going to close with this final statement. Yeasts, molds, all those molds and viruses have been around before us. They're going to be around after us. Humans need to change the environment they live in. They don't need to eat contaminated food. You don't want to get cancer. Do you don't want to touch corn or anything like that that has mycotoxins? You want to live safe. That's the whole purpose of this show, is me donating my time to make sure that you're only going to eat safe food. Thank you very much.